Hello, and welcome to the ride of the resurrection of the mighty Hannibal. This is very important that I share this with you about my so-called resurrection. I never really went anywhere. But thanks to my peers and my contemporary, the year 2011, they seen fit to sample one of my songs, and the people that I'm talking about, we go way back to 1965 when I recorded a song called Hymn Number 5, one of my classics that I cut. And at that time, in our group in development, the people that I'm talking about, first of all, I'd like to praise God and thank them for helping me come back in this business. And for those who had they put on my head and thought I was gone away, I'm back. Now, Elton John, Leon Russell, T-Bone Burnett, and Cameron Crowe are four people that is very instrumental for this ride. So I want you to hold on to your seatbelt as I tell you a wonderful story. Leon Russell was doing an album in 1965 called Live Leon in Atlanta. And he said on the album, this is the hometown of the mighty Hannibal. At that time, Hymn Number 5 was on fire. And he was like in his start in the business, he started right behind me. And Elton John was a piano player for Major Lance. So we all came up in the same time together, and they never forgot me in those times, because when Leon Russell mentioned Hymn Number 5 to T-Bone Burnett and Elton, Elton said, well, now, wait a minute, I can't talk about no Walt. Here's a man that sold 500 million albums, and Leon Russell, Hall of Fame songwriter, A Song for You, This Masquerade, George Benson, and If It Wasn't for Good, Wouldn't Be Bad, that's on this Union album. So when they suggested Hymn Number 5 to Elton, he asked them to write something to the part, There's No Tomorrow, There's Only Today. And if we pick up our newspaper at this time, it looks like that the world is in an uproar. It's a danger zone everywhere, and there's no tomorrow, it's only today. So it's very timely today that that song is out. And one of the verses in it says, there's no time for waiting, no future do I see, besides the next moment might never be. There's no easy answer to the question at hand. It says, now, there's no tomorrow. It says, there's only today. And when you look around you and you see what's going on, people killing people, it is something about that that is meant by God for it to come out. Now, Cameron Crowe did a documentary on HBO. I must say this. He graduated to where he don't have no B team. Everybody he got on the list is an A team. And I'm flattered and grateful to be on the ride for the whole album. The whole world heard me around the world, 40 times on HBO. And they saw, every time they saw Leon name in print and Elson's name in print, my name was there too. So I'm proud that my name feels on the same record with producer, Oscar-winning producer, T-Bone Burnett, Hall of Fame songwriter, Leon Russell, and multi-talented pianist and singer, Elton John. So now, I'm not knowing what they're doing. Elton's manager called my record company, Northern Records, and wanted to get in touch with me. some of that, I'm being real. I don't like to pull phoniness. They said this guy's name was Jenkins. I said, that sounds like a brother. I said, oh man, I don't want to hear that. I just begin my number anyway. So when Elton came to the phone, he showed me some gratitude for something that other people never showed me. He let me know that I'm on the A team, I'm part of that, his growing up and his molding by the statements that he said to me on the video that you're gonna see in a minute. Now, we all came up in this business together, and some of the people in the business didn't like the way that I did business, tried to put me up under the bus. Say again, I'm back. Now, I want you to pay very close attention to this, what Elton said about me, because this to me is more valuable than being in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame when your own peers pay you disrespect. Listen up. Thank you. Watch this a minute.
Hi, is that Hannibal? Is Elton John? Yeah. I'm a singer and a piano player. I make records, and I just wanted to call you because I've just made a record with Leon Russell, who was my idol, and we've used your song "There's No Tomorrow."
Hymn number five.
Hymn number five. Yeah.
There's no time for waiting, no future to see. Inside the next moment, nothing might be. The answer's not certain, no time to decide. Is this the last curtain? There's no place to hide. There's no tomorrow. There's no tomorrow. There's no tomorrow. There's only today. Outside of death's door, there's no easy answer to the question at hand. So easy to ask and not understand.
No.
thank you so much for looking at that clip and listening to that song. Because if we look at what is going on, some of the most horrible things that are going on in the world, I mean, we can't run, we can't hide from the destiny of this whole planet just about to blow up. So I'm not preaching to anybody. I just want you to know that I'm grateful to my contemporaries for taking me on this ride and letting people know that the mighty Hannibal is back. Now, I'm on this same ride I've been riding on. You want to know where I've been? Here's where I've been. I'm blessed to have a song in the Django Unchained, Quentin's new movie. And I want to take a chance on messing up his last name, but Django Unchained, Quentin is the writer of it, called Who Did That to You, that was sampled by John Legend, and the co-producers is John Legend and Kanye West. And it was also rewritten by Paul Epworth. Now, they was on a gig in France, and the song was previously in a movie, The Right to Love You, called The House of Tolerance in Les Palamedes in French, which I tell you the truth, it was a what they call a cult movie. In other words, it was a skin flick movie. Let me see, be nice. So they sing the song, and they heard baby, they heard that, and they decided that they were gonna put it in the movie. So I'm thankful to everybody that was involved, or jail, they all was at the movie to see this, involved in calling this song to be in the movie. The movie has been very, very, very successful. So there's more people around the world that I know. Now, it's supposed to be an album coming out, sometime I understand, on John Legend. And I'm hoping that I'm in it. And I'm grateful for them coming to my plate and sampling out of my plate and letting me have a younger audience that I don't have. Now, I'm hoping, like I say, that it be in the album that they're putting out. Now, there's one more thing I want to say about this segment before we end it. There is a chance for you young people to learn something from this business. When you sample somebody's stuff, always pay homage and credit the way Elton John them is paying homage and credit to me for where you got your stuff at. But I'm going to give you some good advice. If you don't bring nothing to the table, you don't deserve to eat. If you're all around about, as much as I need the money, I'm going to tell you the truth. If you're all about running around sampling this and sampling that and don't bring that to the table, nobody's going to know anything about you. You got to be able to create some songs yourself and put your own image out there. My contemporaries looked out for me. They come back and said, "Here, Hannibal," and get him and bring him back. James Brown, he's gone. Joe Tex, he's gone. A lot of my friends are gone, and a lot of them are still here. The late Dennis St. John, my brother that played drums with me, that helped me in my career quite a bit. Now, I'm saying this to you young people, and I hope you take this advice, and not saying I'm beating up on you, because I want to see you bring something to the game. If you don't, you're going to self-destruct and nobody going to remember you. So, until next time, the next ride, thank you so much.
I don't want to be the one that hurt you. That cause you pain. Hey, somebody find me a preacher so I can buy the rights. I wanna love you. stronger. If I don't get you, I don't think that I can last too much longer. Somebody go fetch me a preacher so I can buy the rice. I wanna love you. Listen, baby. Hand in hand, we gonna walk down that aisle together. Forever. Hey, 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 hey. Someone bet me a preacher so I can buy the rights.